Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today the 2nd of January, Holy Mother the Church calls us to the memory of Saints Basil the Great and Gregory Nazianzen. Both of them were great friends and both of them come from families of saints. Saint Basil the Great, his parents, grandparents, his brother, his sister, all of them were saints. The same goes with Saint Gregory Nazianzen too. So this was how they really became saints. They weren't martyred for Christ, but their life they lived for Christ. And Basil the Great was a scholar, was a geometrician, an astronomist, a medicine-oriented person, and so many things. He was well-versed in rhetoric, philosophy, geometry, astronomy, medicine. All of this he studied from Athens. And then later he was influenced by Macrina to turn his mind towards the spiritual pursuits. And that's how he was ordained as a priest in 364 by Archbishop of Eusebius, Archbishop of Caesarea. He was also elected to succeed him as the Archbishop of Caesarea. And later he was visiting Syria, Palestine, Mesopotamia, Egypt. And 5 years he was there as a hermit. And it was later that he, in his own property, started a monastery and kept the motto as prayer, study and work, which brought him this title called the Father of the Eastern Monastic Life. The faithful observance of the canons by clergy and laity alike rendered the diocese of which he was the bishop as the title of being a very organized and systematic diocese in that era. And later, his love for the poor, the sick, the ostracized, the lepers, and so much of care that he took for his people that he brought up new schemes like for training for the unskilled labor, supported the social causes and responsibility of the wealthy, and so many things that he did. Basil himself practiced Christian precept of ascetic poverty, so much so that he did not have anything with him. Outstanding among doctrinal teachings, he is the doctor of the church, the father of the church, and he is known for his treatise on the Holy Spirit and the Eucharistic liturgy. His friend, the other saint of the day, Saint Gregory of Nazianzen, or Gregory Nazianzen, like Saint Basil, was, as I already told, from a family which was filled with saints. When studying at Caesarea, he met his friend Basil the Great, and both of them at the age of 31, from 31 to 37, they lived a life like monks, and then they came back and they became bishops. 11 years later, Basil, who had meanwhile become the metropolitan, consecrated him bishop against his will. So now his friend Basil becomes the metropolitan, means the in charge of 4-5 bishops. So this metropolitan has a responsibility of choosing bishops for areas under him. So he chose his own friend Gregory. So Basil chose Gregory Nazianzen as the bishop. And as a bishop, he did a lot of service, and in 379 called the Constantinople the stronghold of Arian heresy. He became the bishop of that area and was really instrumental in getting rid of Arian heresy in that place. So both of these saints, known for their wisdom, knowledge and understanding of the scriptures and as good shepherds of the church, today stand to us as models and challenges so that we can give our life totally to Christ. Amen.